Say hi.
Hi.
Talk to her.
What are you doing, Henri? Don't you be out smoking. But she don't fight me that I'm going to go faster. They don't know how long I got, what they think.
That's right.
They don't want their best one. But she's coming down again in the morning.
You got as long as you want, don't you?
That's right. That's what probably longer.
No.
Then I mean, you know, I don't believe that that spirit ever dies. Your body has to go back to earth, but your spirit... And science have proved this. They weigh you right before you die. They didn't mean to say that. You ought to be a little lighter. Good, that's what you get with.
I thought that was your stomach.
Oh, geez, Mom.
Good God, that was that guy.
No, I went like that. I said, man, I hope that's not her stomach.
What are you?
They better put you on a diet.
And poor old Doug, he's something now. The rain just run him home. And he said, he told me, he told her, I'll go stay in that door and take it. Poor old Doug. Yeah, and he said, nobody's going to come and take it. You're going to get help, and they'll be there constant. Yes, nurse. But she was right. I should have got so upset. Now I don't care.
Well, yeah. It's all right to get upset. I would have, too. I've
been 40 years in a place, and I was thinking, there goes the house, there goes the car, there goes my thing, goes my cats.
They're taken care of.
And finally, I thought, well, you got so you can't take care of them. But Andy tried to get me out of that bathroom.
Yeah.
In little black balls room. And he goes, hey, pitiful. And now I guess he thinks I run off of that. No, he likes Dollar. He likes people.
Yeah.
The time Andy gets him down there, he'll be rotten.
Animals know stuff. He knows.
Oh, yeah, I know that. So I said, I don't want to see it.
Yeah.
None of it. Although I could go in the house. I just didn't want to see them no more. Yeah.
Okay.
Because, you know.
Yeah.
And I want you to do something else. You know, back there in the window seat,
mm-hmm.
is Reese ready for Christmas. Take them and put them in your house.
Oh, sweet.
You know, I fixed them myself and got the ribbon on.
Oh, yeah.
And take them down in here.
Okay.
Take them home and decorate your windows.
All right. I need wreaths for my windows.
Yeah, then you got the hook.
Perfect. That's what I needed.
Yeah. You want some water?
Yep.
Yeah.
Let's see. Let me give you a straw.
Oh, here we go.
There we go, yeah.
Well, they just got it.
I know. This is such a nice place.
Just couldn't ask for a better place than this.
I know.
And you don't even have to do nothing.
No.
You can just rest.
I just can't do anything. Mm-hmm.
But you don't even have to try. Who cares, man?
Yeah.
It's bitter. Because that, you know, it worries you. I mean, I know I've not been able to do housework for really a couple of years. And I thought, well, Donna does real good. We don't worry about the front part.
Mm-hmm.
And she'll strip my whole bed and go in there and take Andy's litter box and take it and clean it. And just, you know, keep my clothes washed and folded around me in the bags. And
she's a gem.
And she lives so close to me here.
You know what? It only took me 15 minutes to get here.
Man, good.
15 minutes.
Awesome.
You go, girl.
Well, that's what she told me. Miss Handy told me. She said, you're close to Judy. You're close to Allie. Not far from Jeff. Donna's close. I said, yeah, you're in Lexington. Really mad. You know,
I would have been too.
Just think of being someplace 40 years and all of a sudden somebody comes in the morning, you feel so good anyway, drunk in that drawer. I'll be drunk. I thought I'd get a hold of it.
I'm not smuggling in your booze. Quit asking me.
No, but it is. But all of a sudden, I got real peaceful and I thought, hey, this is what you need to do. I thought, before you do something else idiotic, which is hard to do. And she said, you can do anything you want to. I'm not taking this bank book so that you can't use it. We'll both use it. I said, but you can turn anything into me and I'll pay it. I said, okay, well, I'll have that mean coat, ain't it? You'd be turned into house too. No, I just teased her. I apologized to her. She says, Aunt Laura, you think I don't know how that hurts you to give up things? And I said, I don't. Oh, and she had called me baby and said, but when you call me, did they? Because that got me worse than anything. If I thought I had to euthanize him, I'd never left.
Well, Marianna would have took him.
Yeah, we wouldn't have let that happen.
I just couldn't do that. But so she went to talk to Lindy, but not in front of me. She came back and Lindy said, why, yeah, should you do that?
Oh, man.
So I thought, yeah, that's what I thought about. The live things like this for most of those who go somewhere else. Mm-hmm. You know, like, you know. And back there's a pretty place for me. That's coming back here.
Man, tomorrow go out there.
Well, I don't know, tomorrow's when the house will be full.
Make them go outside.
Yeah, make them go out there.
But I'll wait someday when they can take me out in a wheelchair so I can really see.
That's right.
She said I could. She'd go out.
Do you want me to do anything at your house?
Not now. Don's been there today. And I'll have, well, Donna has the game in tomorrow, right. But she'll, every day, she'll do stuff. You know?
Yep.
So, I don't worry about when Donna's around, because she says, I'll never let nothing happen.
No, you can trust her.
Well, yeah. Because she may not go early, but she always, when she goes there, she piles out the food like I told her. And she knows that she can go and get stuff and that I would pay her. But they don't need them. As soon as they're gone, she has to go in with.
Yeah.
And you guys can get the food cleaned out of the refrigerator and the pantry.
Want some of that?
Hey, there's a church. It's St. Joseph's. And a couple of days ago, some guy knocked on the door. And, well, the house was a little slow, open the door. And he just told me that he was from St. Joe's. And he wanted to bring me a little gift from God. A little white bag, at Kroger, or it was real small, and full of this stuff.
Oh.
Pens and pencils. Oh. Eyes, things to put around your eyes if you understand.
Oh, wow, that's what these are?
That,
yeah.
Yeah. There's a white bag.
How nice.
Oh, open that door on top. The door, honey.
This?
Yeah. Now,
there.
Them bags was full of all kinds of stuff.
Wow. Awesome.
Well, then a woman come and brought another bag. That's why there's two. I said, one bit enough. So this guy said, nice looking fella. He's probably about Jesus' age.
Hey, watch that.
She's a nice looking fella.
I didn't tell him your age, I was guessing his.
Here, take my bat radio. I looked it up this morning. That class of missile receives on a wavelength of 164.1. I'd say the odds against it would make even the most reckless gambler cringe.
Oh, thanks.
I know.
It's so pretty out there in the deep.
Yeah.
So I think I'll be fine. I can't bring many clothes out here until it fits through.
Well, your closet's kind of big.
Thank God that will go every day.
Hey. It'll hold your main thing, your red coat.
Yeah.
And your brown coat.
Yeah.
And your brown shoes.
And your brown shoes.
Well, I'm asking, I got some pretty white storage bags that sit. If I could put one on top of them, it couldn't hurt nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just have to.
Yeah. You ought to put your earrings on.
Yeah, I want to bring stuff.
Yeah.
It's pretty good, and, you know.
Yeah, I'll have Donna get your earrings.
No, I will finally, but I mean, I'll have my daughter to go over, and I've already mentioned that my wedding ring and my arms and my diamond and my wedding band that Melvin gave me got married. But that's to be buried with me, a ring from Melvin.
Yeah, you don't want to get up there and have him say, where the hell is it?
I said, I put it to hell. In fact, I would think, I think it's Warren too.
You know what, I think it is too. Didn't we talk about that one?
Yeah, I thought about having that rebuilt so I could wear that.
Well, let's tell Aunt Cindy you want that done.
It's at home, I can't get to it right now.
Where's it at?
Oh, you can't?
In your underwear drawer?
Smart. Yeah.
What else you got in that underwear drawer?
Whiskey.
A bottle of liquor.
Well, I can tell everything.
Let's go. But inconspicuously. Through the window.
So here I put my diamond and mom's ring and my wedding band. And I've got a good pair of gold bills. Not expensive. I don't have expensive jewelry. But maybe this winter we can go up there and I can go with this.
Yeah.
Try and get my legs to go up.
Sure.
Yes. Let the cats get away.
Yeah.
Right. Get the red coat.
Yeah.
You can take a day trip.
The red coat's here.
Oh, yeah, it's in there.
Holy cow.
Well, that's my coat I always like to. So we'll go up after the holidays.
Yeah.
And,
right. All right, we'll do that.
See, you don't want me to take out. Because they said, you don't have to sell the house right away. Don't worry about it. I said, Lord, no, Christmas is only 30 days away.
Hey, don't remind me.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
It's coming up fast.
Shoot. Marianna's the crazy one that goes on those Thursday night.
Black Friday
thing.
Marianna, I'm going tomorrow. I'm leaving at 9 o'clock at night tomorrow night.
A lot of houses have been there.
Sherry's going with me and Joyce, Mamaw, and her friend.
Who else said they were going to go? I can't
probably
remember.
Brenda or Joyce or something. Did they do it?
They probably don't.
They're
too old. Yeah.
Hey, they're not too old. Mama does it.
She needs another drink,
well,
I think.
I imagine, honey, you could get a lot of things on.
She needs another drink. Oh, I thought you meant refill the pitcher. I was like,
no.
You ought to take that little chair home, honey, that Uncle Larson.
My white one?
With a little heart shape. Mm-hmm. You ought to take that stuff home with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That little Lawrence, not Lawrence, Uncle Melvin and Robert made them.
Mm-hmm.
And that little church is as solid as
I know.
Jeff's girls tore apart.
Is that surprising, really?
Because I said, Mary, you had strawberry shortcake. And I thought, well, we'll have Marianna one in chairs, I decided. And I thought, well, I felt bad. I had one for Jesse and Jenna. And they didn't have a table, but you had strawberry shortcake. So they looked at your table, your strawberry shortcake, and they just a plain white little table. Do you know they Beth and them didn't throw that away. They kids was like, wow.
Was? What do you think they still are?
They are. But oh, Jenna was here the night on Bay Price.
Yeah.
But I feel so much. Jenna does come up and see me.
Mm-hmm.
I give her that. You remember the girl that looked just like Jenna?
Yeah.
Who? The nurse.
At the hospital.
She looked like Jenna?
Just exactly.
Beautiful. She was more aglow than
Yeah, she than was Jenna. A little... Yeah.
Aglow, but just, I said, and I didn't see her really. I says, and she was working on me, the blubber, I guess, lighting it up. Anyway, she just looked at me, she told me something. I said, Marianne, I said, who she look like? Marianne said, Jenna.
Yeah. She sure did, too.
Just exactly.
Yeah, she did.
and she's a glow, though, you know.
Yeah, she's a little, healthier looking, maybe?
Yeah. Yeah, really
not
healthy.
In a bad way, but you know.
Yeah. But I feel sorry for Jen. I said to Jen, you still live with that guy? Yeah. Well, I says, how's that little boy? He said, he done turned up the house tonight. I said to Jeff, they gonna get married? Jeff said, Aunt Dora, you don't know what Jen is gonna do.
Hand me down the shark repellent bat spray.
Hey, it's true.
Yeah. He said, we know that. I said, you rent your house? He said, yeah. She lives in Westchester.
Yeah, with that guy.
I said, you be good to him.
Oh, she will.
She loves kids.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah.
She would never be. Mm-mm.
No.
I said, Jesse got ready for a wedding. She said, she keeps changing her mind what she's going to do. I mean, not that the wedding ain't on. She don't know she likes this or that.
Yeah.
I don't think I even knew Jesse was getting married.
Did she?
Yeah. Oops. I don't know.
Jinx sometime.
Well, hi, Mariana. I barely even said hi to you. What happened? Is your eye? Is there something wrong with your eye?
No.
Right there? It's a shadow.
I don't know. Is there something wrong with me?
I ain't going to tell you if you don't know it.
Lots.
I hate to decide.
I know.
I hate to tell people.